Hello, this is Todd Foisey with the National Weather Service in Caribou, and I'm going to talk about one of the most common questions we get here at the Weather Service is how do you obtain climate information, say daily or monthly normals, past data, and things like that. So on our website, which is up here at the top, weather.gov/car, you can go to climate and past weather, click on past observed weather like this right here. That'll take you to this page. So let's start with this observed weather tab. You can look at the daily climate report, CLI, for Bangor, Caribou, Houlton, Millinocket, and Frenchville. Let's just look at Caribou. Let's look at the most recent climate report, and let's see what we're looking at here. So here's the climate report put out at 1:30 a.m. Saturday. So this is the climate report for June 20th, which was the day before, Friday. Got a high of 60, a low of 65. Here were our normals. So you can see it was running well below normal, 13 degrees below normal for the high, 6 below normal for the low. You can see what happened last year on this day. You can see yesterday we got a trace of precipitation, the month-to-date precipitation, which is 1.99. That's the average is this 2.22, so we're running a little bit below normal. And there's a bunch of more stuff here, like snowfall data for the day and year-to-date. Some heating and cooling degree days if you're into that, wind speed, sky cover, weather conditions that were observed, relative humidity, some records. The record for today was 92. And also you can see the sunrise and sunset, and finally down here at the bottom, soil temperature data that we take right here at NWS Caribou. The soil temperature at 4 inches down was 68 and 61 for the high and low. So you can get that also for days in the past. You could click archive data right here and go back in the past, get the data for, you know, a day back back to April 21st. And I'll show you how you can go back further than that in a minute. You can also look at preliminary monthly climate data. So let's click on Bangor here. Let's look at the most recent. That'll be this June. And you can see the daily data for this June from the 1st through the 20th. The highs and lows, precipitation, snowfall, of course no snowfall, and how we're running month to date for temperature and precipitation. So running a little bit above average for temperature, below average for precipitation. And you can also get these for a bunch of months in the past for Bangor and any of these other sites. You can see some record event reports. That's if there was a record high or low. And so you see not every day is listed here. You can look at the monthly weather summary, which is a narrative of what's happened over the past month. So you can see a narrative here for, this is actually a narrative for spring of 2014. Coldest March on record for many areas, and it goes on with a summary of what happened throughout the spring. You can look at a regional summary for Maine. Let's look at the most recent one. There you can see the highs and lows throughout the region and the temperature, and the precipitations. So here's some various sites in Maine for yesterday and into this morning in New Hampshire. Now let's go to another tab. This is a tab called Now Data over here on the right. You have access to a whole bunch of information. So you can look at the daily data for a month, for any month, for any of these sites, Caribou, Bangor, and some other sites around the state. They aren't all available for all time periods, but you can click on it and see. But let's just use Caribou here for this example. So daily data for a month. Let's say I want to go way back in time. How about May of 1997? Let's look at the daily data for that month and see there we've got it. The highs and lows, precipitation, snowfall, snow depth. So you can go at any month in the past for these stations. You can look at the daily almanac. This is like that daily climate product that we saw kind of. So you can see, of course this is missing because it hasn't been finalized yet for today, but you can look at this information for any day in the past for any of these stations. You can look at monthly summarized data. So for example, we could go back to 1940 and look at the precipitation, the sum of precipitation for each month. So this is showing monthly precipitation for all these months, all the way back from the current year back to 1940. So lots of data here to look at. You can look at calendar day summaries, daily monthly normals. So if you want to know what maybe the daily normals are for temperature and precipitation for Caribou, here you go. You could see if you're planning maybe a wedding on October 1st and want to know what would typically be expected, you would typically expect on October 1st an average high of 59, low of 39. You can get a little bit of idea of what may typically be expected for that day. Of course, conditions can vary significantly. climatology for a day, first last dates, you can use this and some of the advanced options to get maybe the first last day you would expect a freeze, for example. I won't go through a search here, but there's a lot of powerful stuff you can do with first and last dates. And you can even look for first and last dates of certain snowfall and snow depth thresholds. You can look at some temperature graphs. So here's a temperature graph for Caribou for 2014. The blues are the observed temperatures for highs and lows. The reds are the record highs. Blues are record lows. And then this brown range is kind of the average range. So you can kind of see where and when we are running above and below normal for temperature and all those variations for each day. You can look at accumulation graph of precipitation for any date range you choose. This will be this year so far. So you can see for Caribou here in this green line, you can see 2014 accumulation. We're running above the average, which is this brown line right here. So we're running above average. You can see our wettest year, 2011, was actually quite a bit wetter than what we are right now. And the driest year here in red. So this is a pretty cool way to look at accumulated precip through the year for most of these sites throughout the forecast area. One other tab that I'll point you to is this local data slash records. Here you can quickly download, quickly download comma separated values, which you can put into Excel pretty easily for max, min, precipitation, snowfall, and snow depth for Bangor and for Caribou. So you can get this into Excel and do some calculations on it. And also there's a web page right here called Caribou Top 10. We don't have a top 10 for Bangor yet, but you can go here and see, for example, what the, let's say, the top 10 snowiest years were, or the top 10 snowiest winters. So you can see on this graph here, 2013-2014, Caribou, we had 151 inches of snow, and that you can see that ranks number 6 for the snowiest winter. So it was a nice snowy winter this past winter, and this was updated May 2nd, 2014. So a lot of information, climate information that you can get from our webpage. If you want to obtain more information, you can either go to the National Climatic Data Center, or you can give us an email and we can try to point you in the right direction. Our email here is carwebmaster@noaa.gov. And we would love to answer your questions. Thanks for your time. Have a great day.